Now, I wanted to ask you, of course, this is coming from different sources. Perhaps you can confirm this for me. Is it true that you've already been offered by President Marcos Jr. to be the Secretary of Health, but you've turned it down? Is this accurate?
No, ma'am. Okay. Honestly, it was not offered. I was asked to be an OIC, and I was able to explain to them also my reservations. And he just said that we just continue to do the work and then we will discuss further.
Okay. Now, so it is true that you have reservations if you are offered as Secretary of Health. And I wanted to ask you, because I did speak with Congresswoman Garin the other day, and she did say, for someone like yourself who is a career official, would it affect your tenure in the end? Is this one of the factors, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, I think most of us career officials would be thinking like this because we have spent our career. I had been here for almost 3 decades already, and I am a career official. So kapag may mga term po kasi tayo, kapag ganyan, it's just only 6 years.
Oh,
and by the time I finish the 6 years, I still have years left to serve.
Yun.
And I want to still serve, of course, until I retire. So isa ho yan sa reservation. But as I always say, if I am here for service, ito pong mga ganitong rason, syempre, we set it aside. Mm-hmm. And if really want to serve. So we will see po in the coming months or days kung ano po yung magiging desisyon ng ating presidente. Basta tayo, tuloy-tuloy lang po tayo magtatrabaho.
Okay. The Alliance for Health Workers is, of course, against the appointment of Cascolan. They said it's a slap in the face of health workers. But what's interesting is in my interview yesterday, I was surprised to find out that Robert Mendoza, the Alliance of Health Workers, also don't support your possible appointment as health secretary because they said you defended former Secretary Duque when he was secretary. Let's talk about this. I mean, there's the chain of command. You have to speak with one voice. But what do you make of the Alliance for Health Workers having that opinion about you, considering you are a career official with the agency?
Well, that's their opinion, ma'am. Hindi naman po natin pwedeng i-please lahat ng tao. I cannot force them to like me.
Mm-mm.
But what I can say would be, I do not defend people. I defend the institution. And I am here to serve our institution and not to serve anybody. Ang akin pong pinaglilingkuran, ang taong bayan, pati po ang Department of Health, ang aking dinedepensa.
Okay. All right. Now, you are still the officer in charge, but what would your target be during your tenure as Department of Health chief that would be different from, let's say, what the former Secretary Duque has left, considering in a way you are both handling the agency with COVID-19 as a problem?
Unang-una, ma'am, we are trying to shift our direction and the mindset also.
Yeah.
There are still non-COVID programs that we need to focus on. And what would be my banner program would be primary health care. So I've been going to these areas where the marginalized are there. So IPs po natin, yun po mga mental health patients po natin. Tinitignan po natin kung paano natin ma-integrate ang primary health care at masimulan ulit, no? Ma-re-establish ulit ito po mga ganitong klaseng programa aside from the COVID that we are trying to manage. We like to look at the marginalized sector kung saan mapakita natin that they too can access our services. So this is part of what we are doing right now. And hopefully, as long as, you know, the time that is being given to me, meron naman tayong magawa na at least output regarding these programs that I had been saying.
Okay. Now let's talk about the 2023 budget. What are your biggest concerns so far? Of course, the 2023 budget is what they call a no additional tax budget to fund this particular GAA. But what is your concern with the Department of Health? Like, for example, nalagyan na po ba yun ng pondo pagdating sa allowances for health workers? I know the DBM has recently released $1.04 billion for the special risk allowances, but this is not enough. But meron na po ba ito for 2023?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, yan po yung biggest concern ko regarding our 2023 budget would be the health allowance of our healthcare workers. Because as I always say, and based from our computations, we need at least 76 billion pesos for 2023 to cover the entire year for all of our healthcare workers receiving this allowance. Mm-mm. But we were only provided 20 billion for our healthcare workers allowance. So meron pong unprogrammed na budget pa na 19 billion. Uh-oh. But if you add this to, this just comprises around 39 billion. Kulang pa rin po to make the 76 billion. Oh, and aside from that, we have arrears. May utang po kami sa ating mga healthcare workers na yun po previously pa noong 2021 pa because of the law on this health emergency allowance na nagsabi kailangan retroactive pay sila from July 2021. So nag-incur din po kami ng arrears na hanggang sa ngayon po, of course, we are working with the Department of Budget and Management para makahanap po tayo ng pondo para dito.
Oo. So this is really tragic for health workers that a law was made pero walang pondo to actually fund the law, right? So paano po ito, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Actually,
go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. The law did not have funds actually. Kaya nga po, we're trying to work with the Department of Budget and Management if for kung saan po tayo pwedeng makakuha pa because these are arrears. Iba pa ho ito dun sa kakailanganin natin for the 2023 budget.
Mm-mm-mm. So ang tanong dito, no, in the 2023 budget, etong 20 billion that's programmed for the allowance of health workers, a 19 billion additional that's unprogrammed, this will not pay for the arrears, yung kumbaga utang sa past allowances ng health workers natin at the height of COVID, ito ba ang pambayad po ng utang o ito yung moving forward for 2023 use?
Yes, ma'am. This would be for the 2023 use. So, yun pong arrears po natin, yan po yung hinahanapan ngayon natin ng pondo together with DBM para mabayaran po natin yung healthcare workers natin.
At magkano pa po yun, ma'am, if you don't mind, yung arrears?
It's around 56 billion pesos.
Naku, saan po daw kukunin yun? Did you suggest the intelligence and confidential funds?
We cannot suggest as to where they are going to get the money. We just proposed to them and sabihan po kami ng DBM kung nakahanap na tayo ng pondo.
All right. Anything else you would like to add, ma'am, before we go?
If you may allow me, I'd just like to remind our citizens. Gusto lang ho natin magpaalala, in spite of the mask mandates being voluntary already, sana po maisip natin na it boils down to the decision of each individual. Informed decision po tayo. Alam po that dapat natin ang risk natin. Alam natin kung kailan tayo magtatanggal ng mask. Alam natin kung kailan tayo dapat magmask. So kapag po tayo ay nasa public transport, pag matao ang lugar, kapag po sa tingin natin ay pangit ang ventilasyon ng pinupuntahan natin, kapag tayo ay hindi bakunado, kapag tayo po ay may sakit na iba at nakakatanda, piliin po natin na magmask muna po tayo para better protected tayo. At saka sana po lahat tayo, let's try to have our first booster shots. This is the only protection that can help us para po makaagapay tayo at hindi tayo magkasakit. Lalong-lalo na ngayon na nagbubukas na po tayo ng ating ekonomiya.
Thank you very much. Appreciate you being on the show, Secretary Rosario Vergeire. I'll see you again. You take care, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Maraming salamat po.